Hello everyone, welcome to Masterminds. Today we are dealing with the third chapter from class 6 history in the earliest cities. In this chapter we are discussing about the characteristic feature of the earliest cities, that is Harappan cities. First we can look at the story of Harappa. The Harappa is located in the present day Pakistan. And it is founded by archaeologists about 80 years ago. And archaeologists found it is one of the oldest cities in the Indian subcontinent. And the sites usually found similar to the Harappan sites. Harappan buildings and other things were described as Harappan. Example, Mohenjo-daro, Lodhal, Kalibangan, Dholavira. All are generally classified into Harappan cities because the Harappa is the first discovered site. So all the sites having similar buildings or other things were described as Harappan. And the cities, these cities were developed about 4700 years ago. Next we can look at the characteristics of cities. These Harappan cities, characteristics of these Harappan cities. Usually it is divided into two or more parts. Citadel. First part is citadel and the second part is lower town. Citadel is usually higher but it is smaller and it is located in the western part of the town. And the lower town is lower, that is it is lower than that of the citadel but it is larger and it is located in the eastern side of the town. And the walls of these towns are made up of baked brick and the arrangement of these bricks are in the interlocking pattern which makes these walls very strong. Means the towns are made up, the walls of the towns are made of baked brick. And the arrangement of these bricks are in interlocking pattern which makes the walls very strong. And there are some special buildings in some cities, that is Great Bath. Great Bath in Mohenjo-daro is a special building in Mohenjo-daro and it is located on the citadel. Note that the Great Bath in Mohenjo-daro is located on the citadel and it is not in the lower town. The lower town is usually for residential purpose and citadel is usually for, these are all assumption, citadel is usually for administrative purpose. And there are evidences of fire altars in Kalibangan and Lodhal. Kalibangan is in Rajasthan and Lodhal is in Gujarat. Kalibangan and Lodhal are Harappan sites. There are evidence of fire altars usually for performing sacrifices. Then there are evidences of elaborate storehouses in Mohenjo-daro, Harappa and Lodhal. Next we can look at the details of Great Bath. Archaeologist shows that these Great Bath are special tanks. They called special tanks as the Great Bath and these special tanks are lined with the bricks. And the bricks are coated with plaster and the Great Bath, these special tanks are made watertight with a layer of natural tar. These special tanks are made up of bricks and these bricks are coated with the plaster and the tank is made watertight with a layer of natural tar. And there are steps leading down it to the Great Bath from two sides, that is from north and south. Then rooms are present on all sides of the Great Bath. In the one side there is well. All the other sides are comprised of rooms and in one side there is well. And from this well water is brought and it is drained out after use. Then it is believed that important people might use to make a dip in this tank on special occasions. That is, it is considered as a sacred place or something like that. Okay, next we can look at the house drains and streets. These houses are, the Harappan houses are either one or two stories high houses and the rooms are built around a courtyard. There is one courtyard and the rooms are built around the courtyard, and they have separate bathing area. Most of the Harappan sites have separate bathing area, and they have a well developed draining system. That is gentle slope in each drain to allow the water to flow down. Then each houses have drainage system, and the connections of house drains are connected to those on streets. The house drains are small and it is connected to the bigger one that is on the street, and these drains are covered, and there are some inspection halls at intervals for the purpose of cleaning. Actually these drains are covered, but for the purpose of cleaning there are some inspection halls at a regular interval of distance. And some houses had wells to supply water. Then smaller drains led into bigger ones. Smaller drains means the drains of houses. These are connected into bigger ones, that is drains on the streets. All the three, that is houses, drains and streets, since these are well connected and integrated, we can say that all the three, that is houses, drains and streets, were probably planned and built at the same time. Next we can look at the new crafts in the cities. We can get the evidences of many crafts item in the Harappan city. There are objects made up of stone, shell and metal. And the metals used are copper, gold and silver. Copper is used to make tools, weapons, ornaments and vessels. Gold and silver is used to make ornaments and vessels. Then there are evidence of beads. Beads are made from carnelian. Carnelian means a special type of polished red stone. And this stone was cut, shaped and polished, and a hole was bored through the center so that a string could be passed through it, and it is the whole process of bead making. Then there are evidence of weights, and these weights are made up of cherts. Chert is a kind of stone, and it is these weighing stones are used to weigh precious stones as metals, that is gold, silver, etc. These are weighed using these weights made up of cherts. And there are evidence of blades, and these blades are made up of stone, and therefore they are known as stone blades. Next, another important material is seals, and these seals were made out of stone, and these are generally rectangular in shape, and the animal figures of animals are carved on them. Then there are pets which are in beautiful black designs. Then terracotta toys. Evidences of terracotta toys are found in Harappan sites. Then cotton. Evidence of cotton is found in Harappan sites. Probably it is grown at Meharga. Meharga is a Neolithic site. Evidence of cotton is, that is a cloth pieces attached to the lid of silver vase, copper objects is found in Mohenjo-daro. This gives the evidences of cotton which might be grown in these sites. This cloth pieces is attached to the lid of a silver vase or copper objects. Then there are spindle wool. Spindle wool is used for spinning thread, and it is made up of terracotta and faience. And what is faience? It is not a natural thing. It is an artificially produced material to make beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels. The faience is made up of clay, which is clay or sand, which is using gum. It is arranged into different forms and give a glancing effect and form different beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels. Next, in search of raw material. What is raw material? First we need to know what is raw material. Raw materials are the substance that are either found naturally, such as woods or ores of metals, or they are produced by farmers or herders. And these are these products are then processed to produce finished goods. Example, cotton. Cotton is a raw material. Then it is processed to produce dresses or material, textile materials. Then in Harappan sites, there are some locally available raw material, and some are brought from different places also. Some are brought from distant places also. Example, copper, tin, gold, silver, precious stones are obtained from different places. Somewhere brought from distant places, copper, tin, gold, silver, precious stones are obtained from distant places. Copper is obtained from Rajasthan. Rajasthan Khitri main is well known for copper, and in Oman in West Asia. Then tin is obtained from Afghanistan and Iran. Then gold is obtained from Karnataka. Then precious stones is obtained from Gujarat, and iron is obtained from Afghanistan. Okay, this is the first part of the lesson. With this, we are done with this session. The second part will come soon. Hope you all.